Beach Arena. Bob Biotti with our expert commentator Kurt Kilgore. We're in the second game, United States women's volleyball in the semifinals against the team from Peru. U.S. won the first game 16-14, but they were ahead 12-3 at one point, and the team from Peru came right back. Now the U.S. leads 13-5 in the second game. Best 3 out of 5 to win, 15 points. And we will be bouncing back and forth. We have so many live events to show you tonight, but right now, 13-6, U.S. over Peru. The winner of this game will play the winner of a match later this evening between China and Japan for the gold medal. And that'll be on Tuesday night, 13-7 now. Peru serving. This is similar to what happened in the first game. Peru coming back. We're looking right now at the top player for Peru, Cecilia Tait. Really one of the best players in the overall tournament. Let's take a look at this again, Kirk.
You can see Debbie Green getting the ball, hands high. Paula Weisshoff behind her. Hits the ball over the block where nobody is.
Okay, Sue Woodstra serving for the United States. They are leading 13-7. They look a lot looser tonight, Kirk.
I think they're more relaxed and they had to be eventually. They can play real well. We're seeing it tonight.
Side out, Peru. This U.S. women's team really has come in here bent on a mission to gain a gold medal. They were bitterly disappointed in 1980 when they were one of the top women's teams in the world not to get to play in Moscow. Seven of the 12 team members stayed together. They've been training for 4 years for this volleyball tournament. 8 hours a day, 6 days a week. Some people say they've trained too much. Some people say that they were just too stiff for the opening tournament, for the tournament. And indeed, they did look like they were pretty tight coming in, as we have a timeout right now, a substitution. Flo Hyman's back in, the big hitter for the U.S. But Kirk, they did look pretty tight in those earlier games.
First three matches they played, they were very tight. A lot of pressure on their own shoulders. They gave themselves it. Looks like they're starting to loosen up. I think they feel they should beat this Peruvian team.
Side out Peru, but the facts of life are that Peru keeps coming back. They're now only behind 13-9. Let's take a look at that block.
Look at his block. Here's a high set to Rita. Both blockers up. They get over the net and block her straight down.
Paula Weisshoff. This Peru team plays with the Asian technique. Rita Crockett, tremendous spike.
After a nice diving save by Debbie Green on a tip shot, teams have been trying to tip this U.S. team the whole tournament. That time, Debbie Green made a diving play to get it up, and the ball was put away by the big hitter.
And Debbie Green is going out right now, being replaced for a moment by Julie Vollertsen, who has been playing very well, but not played much tonight. And we're having Rita Crockett, probably the best overall athlete on the U.S. team, serving. Plans to attend law school when her volleyball days are over. Rita Crockett has a vertical jump of 39 inches. Those of you at home who wonder what that's like, just mark it on your wall and try it. She is some athlete. Once again, this game to see who will go in the gold medal game on Tuesday night against the winner later this evening of women volleyballers from China and Japan. And outside. Good play by the U.S.
Again, that ball was blocked up in the air. Paula Weisshoff, right on the spot, jumps up and hit it straight down.
And now we have serving for the game. It's now 14-9. They win this, they'll be up 2-0. Best 3 out of 5 to win the match. Rita Crockett. Peru, the team that defeated the U.S. in the semifinals in the World Championships in 82, but this for the game. Set by Peru. We'll see a set by Becker. Into the net, side out, Peru.
That time the Peruvian middle blocker was waiting for that quick set to Paula Weisshoff. Had a lot of success, not that time.
Rosa Garcia, number 3, the setter for Peru serving. I just want to get out of the way if that were me up there. I'm not so sure that Rosa Garcia didn't want it. There's Paula Weisshoff really coming on strong.
She's had 10 kills in this game, put away the ball without anybody playing it back.
And she's serving for the game. There's a set by Garcia. Side out, Peru. Once again, you can only gain points while you're serving. 18,000 people saw the United States play Peru in that World Championship match. Side out now, game point again. U.S. in that match, very controversial. A microphone which was plugged into the PA system were used all night to arouse the fans, and the U.S. players couldn't even hear themselves think. Side out Peru. As a matter of fact, they had to change the system after that game because the setter, Debbie Green, they couldn't hear her audibles. They couldn't hear her signals. So now they use hand signals also.
Most of the setters use hand signals. If we get a shot of them sometime, we'll try and show you. They flash signals. Most of the teams use between 50 and 80 plays, offensive plays.
Talking to some of the officials from Peru today, they said that they really were pleased they had reached their goal, getting to the semifinals. That may seem to me that they might be pretty loose here with nothing to lose and everything to gain.
In fact, Bob, we were talking to one of the former players of Peru today who played in a former pro league in the United States, and she was saying they didn't feel they could win. That's a dangerous team to play.
Okay, we can see one of those hand signals right there, Kurt. Now we have Flo Hyman serving for the win, serving for the game. This would make it 2-0. There's the set by Carolyn Becker. Game U.S., so they've won the second game, 15-9. Now they lead 2-0. Best 3 out of 5, and they'll be in the gold medal match against the winner between China and Japan. People here seem pretty excited about this tonight.
Well, the people have been coming out, going to gym every night, and they're seeing great volleyball.
Okay, Jim, that's it from Long Beach. One more game possibly to go for the Americans to move into the final. We'll be going back for live coverage of that. We'll be going back to gymnastics. And very shortly, we're going to have a fight for you from out of the boxing arena. Meldrick Taylor of the United States against Francisco Camacho of Mexico.